Only 5 minutes into game two, and the Pens leading 1-0. The shot heard round the hockey world was fired. The Rangers' Adam Graves took a vicious swipe at Mario Lemieux. And as the Pens superstar crumbled to the ice, visions of a second Stanley Cup faded slowly to black. It was a sad and devastating sight. One that smacked of ugly intent. The sport's most gifted athlete was gone with a fractured hand. If that weren't enough bad news, a little later, Joey Mullen was carried from the ice after a collision with two Rangers. He was out for the season with an injured knee. In an instant, the Rangers erased the league's regular season scoring leader and the team's heart and soul. They also rallied to win game two, 4-2. Back in Pittsburgh for game three, Penguin fans reacted.
I think the man should be gone for the playoffs for as long as the Rangers are in it.
It's just a crime.
It's going to hurt the Penguins. We lost our top gun.
The man who broke Mario Lemieux's hand had been given a 2-minute penalty and unbelievably was on the ice in Pittsburgh for game three. It was an incendiary situation. Code red. There was violent retribution in the air. But head coach Scotty Bowman summoned up his years of coaching experience and directed the team not to retaliate. The Pens' frustration mounted as the villain Graves scored, and the Rangers agonizingly won Game 3 in overtime, 6-5. The loss left many Penguin fans wondering if there was any justice left in the world. Little hope left, a jewel of a performance emerged in Game 4. It was helped by a critical blunder by Ranger coach Roger Neilson. The Rangers had continued to send out their hitmen, and their brutal penalties opened the door for the Penguins. Down 4-2 and on the ropes late in the third period, Ron Francis put on his best Mario act and brought down the house.
Sweep it over to Ron Francis, going to the Ranger line. Francis comes in, shoots, score! He got that one through Richter, and the Penguins make it 4-3.
Not 2 minutes later, Troy Loney sent the Rangers reeling into overtime. It was Ron Francis' curtain call.
Reaching in. So is Francis. Hardy working free, and here's Messier. Can't clear. Steven Elf shooting. Score! Here's Francis scoring! The Penguins win in overtime! Ronnie Francis has scored the game-winning goal! And ladies and gentlemen, Elvis has just left the building. Ron Francis has scored in overtime, and the Penguins win 5-4.
Ronnie had a big night. He had a great series against those guys, and I don't think he was looking. The puck came from Murph, and went off Ronnie's stick and right into the corner, and I was standing right at the post there, and couldn't have been any happier when that thing rolled in. To beat the Rangers, that's a team we really wanted to beat with the Rangers, and because everybody talked about how they were going to mop up everybody, and you know, we had the chance, and that gave us another life.
It was a glorious victory, one filled with justice. Ron Francis was clearly the Rangers' killer in this series thus far. Along with the emergence of Francis came the solid play of the Muskegon line. Three guys from the farm system, Callender, Mikhailov, and Needham. A Against all odds, they evened the series against the league's best team. In Game 5, back in the Garden, Ranger coach Nielsen continued to scratch scores Kerr and Ogrodnik for intimidators Koser and Domi. With Rick Tocchet just back from a separated shoulder, Koser took a run at him, hoping to test his shoulder or force a retaliation. But Tocchet kept his cool. Koser went to the penalty box, and justice showed its beautiful face just seconds later.
Moves it in, getting it back on a man there, Tocchet, hey! Shoots and scores, Rick Tocchet gives the Penguins a 1-0 lead.
Now, Jaromir Jagr would take his turn at center stage. The Rangers continued to take foolish penalties. One resulted in an early penalty shot.
Circles back in his own in 68. Jagr approaches the puck. He goes to the Ranger line. Skates right down the alley. Comes in on Van Beesbrug. His wrist shot. He shoots and scores, and it makes it 2-0. Jaromir Jagr. Oh, Michael Motorcycle.
Jagr's goal ignited the Pens. His heroics were not done. Late in the third period, with the game tied at 2, Jagr bolted into the Ranger zone.
On the right wing, the Jagr takes the lead pass, moves in. One-on-one against Bukum, got around him, he'll still the score! Oh, Jagr gives the Penguins a lead, 3-2. Alfie cow kick. He puts Bukum out on the tunnel going to New Jersey, and then beat Van Beesbrug like a rented mule. The Penguins lead 3-2.
By two boards, I pick out a pass, and I go to one-on-one. I beat him. Bookable, I think, was the defenseman. I got one move to the goalie, and after I've opened net, and I shoot it to the open net. I got lucky.
Jagr took control of the puck and turned Ranger defenseman Bookaboom into a lamppost before beating Van Beesbrug for the winning goal. The score was devastating. 20-year-old Jaromir Jagr had shown them something they do not have. The 4-2 win in front of 16,000 desperate Ranger fans left them dazed. The Pens brought their shocking 3-2 lead back home for Game 6.
It's Game 6 of the Patrick Division Finals tonight, and the Manhattan Maulers, better known as the New York Rangers, up to me moving over to the Civic Arena right about now. Catch the Pens game tonight on KDKA Radio.
To combat New York's roughhouse tactics, GM Patrick made sure the Pens could now counter with a Rick Tocchet. Once Philadelphia's most beloved bad boy, Tocchet always came up big in the postseason. Tonight would be no different.
Francis moves in, goes cross rink, the Bork in on goal, he goes behind the net, centers in front, Tocchet shoots and scores! Rick Tocchet gets the goal, the Penguins lead 1-0. Oh, go ahead, make my day, Rick Tocchet!
It was a very big goal. 52 years of Stanley Cup frustration was weighing the Rangers down. They countered with a goal to keep it close. But midway through the second period, the Pens hero of Game 5, Jaromir Jagr, sent the Civic Arena into a frenzy. Shortly after Jagr's score, 16,000 Penguin fans were rocked by rookie Sean McEachern.
Deflects off his skate. McEachern's got it one more time. A backhander. He shoots and scores his first National Hockey League goal. Sean McEachern. And he's smiling like a butcher's dog. McEachern with his first ever NHL goal.